So guys, it's Anime Music here with a different type of video. So here I got my AKAI EIE PRO audio interface, and it's not broken or whatever, but I'm just gonna show what I'm doing. So currently it's open. It's very easy to open actually. Yeah, like four screws on this side and four on the other. If you take them out, you can just take off the casing, and then you have to unscrew the front as well, which is on my bed over here. And then you can take it off and you can easily unplug everything, because it's all very easily set up for you. So what I'm going to do with this interface, which I want to do for a long as time, is actually put in RGB, just the way that I did with my case speakers right here. It's simple, automatically changing RGB. I did that myself, of course. It's very easy to do, so I'm going to do that with this as well, because there's two bright white lights on this one, and it just doesn't really fit the mood in the studio. I want like almost everything to be RGB to make an interesting, trippy room. So, and I'm also in my new house, which I was going to upload a video of, but I can't because I have no internet on my computer right now. So I have to do this with my laptop, if possible, with hotspot, because I don't have Wi-Fi on my computer at the moment. I'm waiting for my internet, which is coming 15th of April, hopefully. And so from there I will start doing more videos, I guess. But this is just what I'm doing right now. So I'm working on this. I'm not going to do a tour video yet, maybe later. I just wanted to show a little bit of this, because I wasn't even planning on making a video, but if people are interested in this kind of stuff, well, then I'll post that. So I'm gonna change the LEDs in a bit and see from there if it's working properly. So that's all I wanted to say. Peace. So currently we are one step further. It took me a while to get the LEDs to work because of some problems, so I had to do make some extensions. And it works. I got the first one working. I'm gonna put the second one in, and probably two or four, depending on the timing of the LEDs or LEDs, because they're automatically changing, and the timing can sometimes not be the same, and then the color is gonna be weird. I might only use two, but maybe four if it's nicer when the timing isn't right, or when the timing is right. It just depends on how I like it. But it's working. And it's pretty nice. Now I have to set everything up and do more soldering and set everything back up, and then see if I haven't broken my audio interface yet. But yeah, this is quite some interesting stuff. I always wanted to change the LEDs, LEDs. I'm gonna do that in a lot more of my stuff. I just want everything to be RGB or LED driven. So there we go. So we are a few steps further on. I added four lights because there is actually timing issues, but that's pretty nice because now it flows, you know, like that. So it's pretty nice. So what I'm probably gonna do is put two in the front and then two somewhere around here, so it lights up the inputs, the inputs and any hole that's left, you know, anything that's open. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And if that's, you know, if it's not going to be visible or whatever, I will put them back around here, so we have two in the front. But I think it's going to be bright enough to at least show some lights on the inputs of microphones and whatnot. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Hey guys, we are now almost at the end of this project. It's working the way that I want it to work. There's still slight timing difference in the changing of the colors, but that's normal with these LEDs. But everything works, so I'm gonna just turn it on and show. There we go. Now it changes color. It's looking quite nice. You know, you can do a better job if you have quality LEDs, but these ones were very, very, very cheap for a lot of them. And I like them because they just, they're not perfect, but they give you something nice, you know? So I'm happy I've done this. I hope I've not broken my audio interface, of course. but I think I'm doing pretty fine, otherwise it would give me some troubles. But yeah, it's looking fancy. Now I just gotta put the top back up and then test it if it still works, and then there we go. So guys, it works. I tested it, I even played music, I even changed some settings on my keyboard, it's making it audio reactive. Let's see if I can get close. Yeah, there we go. Colors are not super beautiful, but maybe that gives some type of cyberpunk aesthetics or whatever. But for now, like I said, it's nice. It adds something to the studio with my care case and change color that I added myself as well. I'm gonna do more projects where I add RGB to my studio and anything else we. I just like the LEDs, not even only RGB, just anything with LEDs related. So I hope you like this video. If you do so, drop a like, subscribe to the channel if you're new. There will be more videos in the future. Yeah, I got more projects that I'm working on. Some hookahs over there that will be placed on some wood on the wall with some lights behind it. And it's gonna be great as well. Maybe some LEDs or some other lights. Then I got my amplifier that I made, the 2-stack amplifier. With 4 outputs of like 15 or 30 watts, currently hooked up to my 2x15-inch PA speakers that are yeah my bed, because it gives me a kind of like a feeling that I'm in a car, you know, with the big subs in the back. More types of videos like audio related stuff will be coming as well, because I'm an audio geek. A lot of in the electronic direction will be put on the channel, even fucking making gaming PCs and all that stuff. And besides that, I will also do certain music projects or whatever, please, on the channel as well. And studio upgrades and anything electronic, audio and like visual related stuff. So, there we go. Oh, that's that. Well, peace, guys.